We'd like to welcome all of you to St. Joseph Secondary's Ecumenical Service, a celebration of an amazing milestone of 50 years in existence and excellence. I cannot think of a better place other than Cecelia's Chapel, a place of worship, to have this event. I hope you all enjoy being part of it in today's ceremony. Anniversaries are the opportunities to recollect our years gone by with memories made and to cherish them again. 50 years is a major milestone for any institution, as it is for any individual. Our celebration is not so much a festivity, but a solemn occasion to pause and look back at this 50-year journey. This journey, where we have all been united in our purpose in delivering the curriculum, both written and hidden, instilling wisdom in students, which will assist in making smart decisions as future adults and making them stronger in spirit, building morale and self-esteem. So in keeping in line with our theme, stronger in spirit, deeper in wisdom, united in purpose, join us as we get the experience to enjoy the fruits of hard work produced by St. Joseph Secondary, displayed in various cultural items.
We are going to have our opening remark done by Mr. Mustafa. It was on Monday, 22nd, October, 1990. A young T2 science teacher named Mr. Wazir Mustafa started his teaching career at Curup Junior Secondary School on the PM shift. He was completing part-time teaching and full-time job in 1996 and 1997. He acquired his diploma in teaching science. He was instrumental in training the school's Scrabble team that won national trophies. He was appointed as the first head of department in science and physical education in 2007. While acting as a vice principal on the PM shift since 2006, he was on the de-shifting and conversion committee that governed the transition and merging of the two shifts of Curup Junior Secondary to form the newly minted St. Joseph Secondary School, which follows a five-level whole day format. As of December 1st, 2010, he was appointed as the official vice principal of St. Joseph Secondary School and thus was selected to act as the principal of February 6th, 2016, when the last appointed principal, Ms. Cheryl Julian, retired. He has served as an administrative capacity for the last 12 years of the school's existence. Can you join me on stage this morning, Mr. Wazir Mustafa?
Thank you so much, our MCs. I'm going to steal some time because I notice our ministry's representative is not present, nor our PTA representative. On this auspicious occasion of the Ecumenical Service to commemorate the 50th Jubilee anniversary of the existence of St. Joseph Secondary School, formerly known as Curup Junior Secondary, I bring greetings on behalf of the current administration, your humble servant, myself, Wazir Mustafa, Mrs. Mohammed Hoyt, our acting vice principal. The Minister of Education could not be here. She's in Grenada, representing us at CSEC Fora. Our junior Minister of Education was called out to a cabinet meeting this morning. She extends her apologies. Mrs. Habiba Abdul-Jabbar, who ought to be here as well, unfortunately is caught in traffic, as was I this morning. So I would like to greet, in their absence, all of the years of past teachers, students, alumni who are present with us, all our present teachers, current ancillary staff, and students, including our NALIS and MTS representatives visitors and well-wishers. A little bit of history, if you will indulge me. In 1972, the school was established, a little more than 50 years ago. To address educational needs countrywide, the East-West Corridor was the most populous corridor in the country. We were of two shifts, each having 960 students, broken up into 8 Form 1s, 8 Form 2s, 8 Form 3s. Each shift had 30 teachers, with one vice principal on a shift and a principal governing proceedings throughout the school day. The shifting and renaming occurred in 2007-2008, and I see among us that then acting principal, Ms. Porter Samuel, who was part and parcel of the de-shifting and conversion committee in which I was a member, also as acting vice principal on the PM shift. We now have a 5-day format, as many of you would know, 5 levels, 5 years. We have, in addition to our normal quota of rooms, 17 prefabs, all air-conditioned, as recently as Sunday service, up and running. This transition, however, had many challenges, one of which is the playing field was used to build a new school. As such, we had no playing field for PE. So when we entered CSEC, our first year group in 2010, had a phenomenal performance. And in fact, that has continued for the last 12 years. Our highest pass rate is in PE. I welcome Mr. Mirage to some heavy shoes to fill, because he has to maintain that legacy. But not just in PE. The transition took its toll on agri-science. As recently as 2 weeks ago, we had a break-in. Yet agri-science is one of our higher performing subject areas. Kudos have to therefore go out to the teachers that persist in maintaining that discipline, production, and performance in all of these areas. Currently, we have 59 members of staff, even though we are awaiting the appointment of an English teacher. We have one appointed dean, 3 appointed heads. Our acting VP is here. Appointed VP, that's myself. I'm the acting principal, as I said. But we are classes at 875 school. However, we have only 749. Where do those children go? We've had transfers out, we've had dropouts. COVID has hit us for a shot. In 2010, March 13th to be exact, when COVID hit, a senior teacher by the name of Ms. Corby and the current vice principal, Mrs. Mohammed Hoy, came together to create something called a task force to manage, govern, and maintain a virtual platform. This is what we have been using for the last 2+ years, and it continues, and it's been expanded by past and current IT technicians. We now have the assistance of the Ministry of Education in providing UNICEF material, access points, cabling, etc., also digidata, but all of that can't work without the students having devices, the teachers having working devices, and connectivity all around. So it's a lot to handle. But I think for the next 50 years going forward, some of us may not be here, but for the next 50 years going forward, we have a physical format, we have a virtual format. I think we have covered all bases. I want to close with my thanks and praise to all of the organizers of this program. 50 years is a milestone. I am seeing past administrators, I have said before, who groomed me, taught me, and held my hand to ensure that I did not slip, but slips may occur. But for the teachers and students who have stayed the course, I thank you wholeheartedly. These are very trying circumstances, As you would imagine, our school is fraught with difficulties, but we are maintaining it. We are working with what we have, doing the best that we can. These are very trying circumstances, but what is our motto? The will does it. And I see the creator of the motto watching me right now. This is where we stand. This is where we go. St. Joseph's sect will always stand tall. I thank you.
Thank you, our principal, Mr. Wazir Mustafa. One of the many great features of our school, St. Joseph Secondary, is that we are a multicultural and multi-religious institution. So in keeping in line with this, we will now have invocation and discourse done by the many faiths of our school. For the Hindu prayer, I ask Ms. Gopi to please take us with the Hindu prayer. Thank you.
Okay, so I'm asking you all to put your hands together. Om Twameva Mata Chapita Twameva Twameva Bandhu Shasika Twameva Twameva Vidya Dravinam Twameva Twameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva Twameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva Om Shanti Shanti Hari Om. You are the mother, you are the father, you are the relative, you are the friend, you are education, you are wealth, you are everything for me. O Lord, I thank you for all that you have blessed me. Thank you, O Lord, I pray to you.
Thank you, Ms. Gopi. For the Islamic faith, we ask Mr. Hossain to please take us with the prayer.
Hi, good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Islamic faith, I'd like to say a little prayer. I would like to extend to each and every one of you the Islamic salutation of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I will begin with the Arabic, followed quickly by the English translation, so you know exactly what I'm saying. All right? A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin, arrahmanir rahim, maliki yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين انعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين امين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله احد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا احد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل اعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق اذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد اذا حسد Bismillahi Rahmani Rahim. Qul a'udhu bi Rabbin Nas, Malikin Nas, Ilahin Nas, Min Sharril Waswasil Khannas, Allazi Waswisu Fi Sudurin Nas, Min Al Jinnati Wa Nas. Translation. I seek refuge with Allah from Satan the accursed. In the name of Allah, most gracious, ever merciful. All praise belongs to Allah, Lord of all the worlds, the gracious, the merciful. Master of the Day of Judgment, thee alone do we worship and thee alone do we implore for help. Guide us in the right path, the path of those on whom thou hast bestowed thy blessings, not of those who have incurred thy displeasure, nor of those who have gone astray. See, he is Allah, the One, Allah, the independent and besought of all. He begets not, nor is he begotten, and there is none like unto him. Say, I seek refuge in the Lord of the dawn, from the evil of which he has created, and from the evil of the night when it overspreads, and from the evil of those who blow into knots to undo them, and from the evil of the envier when he envies. Say, I seek refuge in the Lord of mankind, the King of mankind, the God of mankind, from the evil of the sneaking whisperer who whispers into the hearts of men, and from among the jinn and mankind. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, Mr. Hossein. Representing the faith of Christianity, I ask Ms. Martha Audan to please say the prayer.
Almighty, immortal, invisible God of wisdom and knowledge, we give you thanks and praise as we gather to celebrate the golden anniversary of St. Joseph's Secondary School. We acknowledge the many blessings you have poured out on this school over the last 50 years, protecting it from harm and from danger. Blessings on all the students who walk those halls, seeking to learn new things and taking delight in new discoveries. Guide their teachers and share their knowledge with their gentleness and understanding, and encourage all their staff, the parents, and the benefactors to help build a healthy learning environment. Bless once again St. Joseph's Secondary School, its teachers, its students, the parents, administrative staff, and fill them with their wisdom and knowledge, and grant that the students and teachers may follow Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life, forever and ever. Amen.
Our address by our PTA President, Mrs. Habiba Abdul-Jabbar. The school cannot be more grateful for the Imam service that is currently in formal PTA effective play. Even though we have not been able to hold a PTA election since the start of the pandemic, the last established executive with its president, Mrs. Abdul-Jabbar, remained hard at work, even to the point of assisting us with the last school repainting project. So can you assist me in welcoming her to the stage, Ms. Abdul-Jabbar?
A pleasant good morning. It gives me great pleasure to stand here for St. Joseph's Secondary 50th anniversary. I'm not 50 yet. My sisters and siblings who went to this school is not 50 yet. But I know others who are 50 and they have taught at the school. They still rate St. Joseph's Secondary as one of the best. They were 3 years before. It was morning shift, evening shift. My sisters and they attended the evening shift. It gives me great pleasure to stand here on their behalf. They are not here to represent. I asked others to represent because I would not have been able to make it today, but I guess the grace of God have me here standing today. I have one son that attended school. He's in Form 5 this year. As Miss mentioned, by the default, I'm still the president. I take great pleasure to bring greetings on behalf of the PTA executive. We have stood our grounds. In this pandemic that we have been through, this is the first pandemic I could say that I have lived through, COVID. We have done something in this school that many other schools have not done. We did hampers. And I am proud to know that we have represented St. Joseph's Secondary proudly. Miss mentioned also in the painting, it was not an easy exercise. We have not completed the projectors yet, along with another local school board, that's what we call it, local school board, LSB. We worked along with them. We worked along with the admins of the school, whether it be from the top, go straight down to the bottom. When we say the bottom, meaning MTS. We worked with the parents. We still stand proud, and you guys look great in your uniform. It's a pleasure to stand here again, as I will say, to represent on the Parents Teachers Association and as a parent of St. Joseph Secondary. I pray that we continue to strive in the best that we can do, and we continue with great success. as we say, the will does it. Thank you.
It is my pleasure for our next address to welcome Mr. Clive Ramjetan, who is a past pupil of the Curep Junior Secondary during the years of 1972 and 1975. He was born in the village of Mayaro in that year of 1958. He started his primary school education in Mayaro, Rio Claro, and Curep before passing his common entrance exam, allowing him to attend the Digo Martin Secondary, and was subsequently transferred to Curep Junior Secondary School, where he then completed his full 3 years of schooling. Upon his graduation in 1975, he achieved special awards in music, arts and crafts, general sciences, and the best all-around student. Mr. Ramjetan then attended the St. Augustine Senior Comprehensive and graduated in 1977. After schooling, he gained employment in one of the largest engineering fraternities in Trinidad, known as Trinidad Engineering and Research Limited. During his employment, he started an apprenticeship program and worked his way to becoming a senior draftsman, construction supervisor, and leaving in the position of engineering assistant in the year 1985. From 1985, he joined the Airports Authority of Trinidad and Tobago in an engineering capacity. He had an overall management for maintenance for both Piako and Crown Point Airports. Let's welcome Mr. Clive Ramjetan.
Good morning, all, and thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to be here at present. I also would like to endorse my colleague, Ms. Central Luman. Can you stand, Central Luman? Also, alumni, former colleague of the school during the year 1972 to 1975. All right, I have brought a speech, but I realize that the speech has shrunk a bit, so I'm going to speak from my head. In 1971, after leaving primary school and being told that I passed for Digo Martin Junior Secondary School, I was very elated and very happy that I was in passed for this, for such a school. It was such quite an experience because as a young man, at age 10 to 11, I had to journey all the way to Digo Martin by getting up 4 o'clock in the morning to arrive in that school for 7 o'clock in the morning. It was very difficult for a young person to be journeying that hour in the morning and using the public transport school system. It was because of that challenge, I eventually applied to be transferred to Curep Junior Secondary, in which I was successful. So here my new school year has started in the year 1972. When I entered the school compound, I was very shocked. I was very excited. The school was huge, large compound, nice facilities, brand, you have plenty equipment, physical education equipment, industrial arts equipment, you know, school children, everything was excited. And as a result, that is where I had started my motivation. And my motivation brought me towards the motto, say, the will does it. During my tenure at the school, I was very good at art. As you heard earlier on, I was awarded the art award, music, general science, and also the best all-around student. Two of my pieces of art made the school won second and third place in the National Secondary Schools Art Competition. And that made Curep Junior Secondary rise above the occasion. You know, there are many things about the auditorium that I would have remembered. We used to use the auditorium to have concerts. We used to have magic shows. We even had many important occasions like a bazaar. I remember you were using the art class to convert it to a daylight disco. And you know that was the start of the 80s. Everybody talk about the 80s being the best time of their lives. and this is where it started. After leaving Curup Junior Secondary, I went to the St. Augustine Senior Comprehensive, and at that school, we only had 2 years to prepare for examination. So it was a serious time ahead. I chose a balance of academic subjects as well as technical vocational arts, where after graduating in 1977, I gained employment in an engineering fraternity. It was one of the fourth largest engineering fraternity in the Caribbean, as well as, of course, in Trinidad. While I was there, I entered in an apprenticeship program, and after staying there from 1978 to 1985, I left in the after completing being the senior draftsman, training young apprenticeship draftsmen who came in after me. I did surveying, I did engineering, I did site supervision, and also at one point in time before leaving there, I was a resident engineer when they were building the Uriah Butler Highway. Today, I feel very proud that while journeying on that highway, I will tell whoever is in the car with me, I supervise this. Yes, I supervise this. I am a product of the junior secondary school system. I was always proud to boast about it because it was something absolutely new to the country and new to the Caribbean, where the government had implemented a new educational system, and this is where the birth of the junior secondary school came into being. In 1985, I entered the Airport Authority of Trinidad and Tobago, and while there, I went into the engineering department and headed some major engineering projects. You may have recalled that BWIA then, Caribbean Airlines being formerly BWIA, you would realize that they invested in wide-bodied aircraft, large aircrafts. And as a result, we had to have an engineering crew to expand the airport for the purpose of those heavy wide-body aircrafts to park. So I was instrumental in supervising those in that project. Also, while there, I was also given the opportunity to head the maintenance of Piako and Crown Point International Airport, now called ANR International Airport. While I was there, I was a young man still looking junior sec, and I was in charge of 133 workers, all big men, strong, hardback men, came, they retired from the military, and they held position as maintenance workers. And imagine I was their boss. They gave me a very hard time. But I said early on, the will does it, I had done it. Yeah? In 1990, I was appointed airport duty manager. I was in charge of the entire airport environment. I worked on a 24-hour shift basis. While holding that position, and just for in case for you to know what that position is, that is the representative of the general manager that has a site presence at the airport. While the general manager is in the head office, tucked away someplace, when I had that presence, I represented the general manager, and that was the portfolio I had. Being in that position, I had a responsibility to ensure that the airport was running smoothly, the operations of the airport. When politicians and ambassadors had to travel, I had to do protocol and take care of them. I met with prime ministers, I met with presidents, you know, I met with ambassadors of different countries, and I even whispered in their ear, you know, that if you could help this one and help that one to get homes, because I did social work privately, and through that, my interaction, I was successful in getting 10 people to get homes and to get grants from the government by just meeting with them privately in the VIP room. Coming out of the airport career, I also administered the SHOGAM. You remember the Commonwealth Heads of Government Conference? I was the man behind the scene was planning that. I witnessed 71 presidents and prime ministers from all over the world came in one day. I witnessed that, and I was in close contact with them to receive them as well. While doing that, I was also in charge of planning the sixth summit of the Americas. Very great experience as well. I was also, one of my achievements in the airport during my tenure is that I was instrumental in leading a group that allowed Piako International Airport to get its airport license. And at that time, Civil Aviation Organization had permitted airports in the world to be certified. Because if it wasn't a certified airport, you would have been considered a high-risk airport. And as a result, insurance fees for air carriers would have been quite expensive. So during that time, we had airports all over the world had to be licensed, and I was successful in getting Piako International Airport obtain its license out of 700 airports approved, out of 22,000 airports in the world that was applying for their license. Piako International Airport get their license. And I was very proud. That was a proud achievement. And you know, finally, in terms of my achievement at the airport as well, you headed the planning drills, disaster drill. Imagine that when you're in an aircraft experiencing a distress and it's coming to land, what would happen is that if for some reason something goes wrong and the aircraft crash, all the emergency responders and agencies in Trinidad will have to know how to be able to manage such an emergency and crisis. And as a result, I planned between two to three drills during my tenure there. In fact, as we're speaking about drills, on this Friday, the airport will be hosting another emergency drill simulation between 10 and 12, where the entire airport will be locked down. People will be pretending that plane crash, disasters occurred, and you will see emergency vehicles emerging from all parts of the country towards the airport. So it was quite an experience during my journey. What brought me to that was my background and my training and my foundation coming out of QREV Junior Secondary. I live by the motto, the world does it. This, I retired in 2018, and now I have my own business. I have my own real estate company, and while providing real estate services, having 33 years of airport experience, I still practice my engineering career. Yeah, still practice that. So I wanted to appeal to students who are here today, and to the teachers, of course, that I have had my legacy. What will be your legacy? Make your school life part of your legacy, right? If I can do it, you can do it. The world does it. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow, that was amazing. Could we give Mr. Ramjatan a round of applause again, please? Yeah. Before we move on, I'd like to pay respects to our representative of Member of Parliament for St. Joseph Secondary, Mr. Cook De Freitas, as well as Councillor Mr. Travis Roach. Moving on, y'all can go ahead. Moving on, for today's item, we have Makeda Henry of 5.1 doing a song item. Makeda is a young and upcoming talented artist who supports school ventures. As such, she performed at our recent Achievement Day that was planned by the school's social committee. During this event, all top performers in each area was given a token. So could we give Makeda a roundly heart of applause?
We are not afraid, although time of fear, when resulting bruising pain, oh, seems like a summer to swiftly blown away. Yet now I'm standing here, my heart so full I can't explain, aching faith and seeking words I never thought I'd say. There can be miracles when you believe. The hope is real, it's hard to give. Who knows what miracles you can achieve?
Wow, that was beautiful. There can be miracles when you believe. One of the many traits we try to instill in our students at the St. Joseph Secondary School. So let's hear it again for Makeda Henry. Up next, I want to welcome to the stage a student who is our current head boy and school's student council president, who is also a model student that optimizes all the values and standards that we expect from our student body. Mr. Andrew Davis, could you please come to the stage?
Excerpt from the complete works of Kyle Gibran. Then said a teacher, speak to us of teaching. And he said, no man can reveal to you aught but that which already lies half asleep in the dawning of your knowledge. The teacher who walks in the shadow of the temple among his followers gives not of his wisdom, but rather of his faith and leavenings. If he is indeed wise, he does not bid you enter the house of his wisdom, but rather leads you to the threshold of your mind. The astronomer may speak to you of his understanding of space, but he cannot give you his understanding of space. The musician may sing to you the rhythm which is in all space, but he cannot give you the ear which arrests the rhythm, not the voice that echoes it. And he who is versed in the science of numbers can tell of the regions of weight and measure, but cannot conduct your theater. For the vision of one man lends not its wings to another man. And even as each one of you stands alone in God's knowledge, So must each one of you be alone in his knowledge of God and in his understanding of the earth. Thank you.
Thank you for that, Andrew. Up next, we have Father Woodruff. Father is a member of the Carmelite Order and a priest in the Roman Catholic Church. He is from Barataria. Father McCall has been a priest for the past 2.5 years and was appointed parish priest of the three Catholic churches here in Maracas Valley in September of this year. Father studied social work at UWE, philosophy at Staten Hall University, New Jersey, criminal justice and reconciliation, and a master's degree in divinity from the Catholic University of America. His ministry experience includes prison ministry, youth and adult counseling, school social work practicum supervision, community outreach, visits to the elderly, and group facilitation. Father McCall enjoys nature, the beach, music, poetry, and time with his nephews. Can you welcome on stage today, Father Woodruff?
Good morning, everyone. So I know with this time period, if you're in school, you'll probably have your class periods and you have a little break, not so? So I'll invite everybody to stand and stretch a little bit. So I know with the air condition and the rain this morning, you could stretch, try to reach your ceiling, touch your toes. For those who might have arthritis, hopefully we have Bengay. And as we remain standing, we pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. As you sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world, and for their sake I consecrate myself, so that they too may be consecrated in truth. I pray not only for these, but also for those who through their teaching will come to believe in me. May they all be one, just as, Father, you are in me and I am in you, so that they also may be in us, so that the world may believe it was you who sent me. I have given them the glory you gave to me, that they may be one as we are one. With me and them and you and me, may they be so perfected in unity that the world will recognize that it was you who sent me and that you have loved them as you loved me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You may be seated. So on behalf of our parish community here, St. Michael's Parish, this St. Cecelia Chapel, we are humbled that you have chosen our worship space to have your ceremony. Similar to the president of the PTA, I was reflecting when I was first approached by one of our church members, Miss Nero, to use the venue. When she mentioned 50 years, I said, well, I'm not really close to that. So it means that that is a milestone. A milestone to celebrate in the midst of so many challenges, the gift of education. A story is told about a person whose job was to be a stone cutter. His job was to climb up mountains and to simply cut stones. So he was doing his job and he looked around at people who were a lot wealthier, doing wonderful things, and he felt embarrassed. Rip up shabby clothes, very little money. So he prayed to God one day. He said, God, you know what? I don't like being a stone cutter. I want to be the king. His prayer was answered. He became the king. So he had servants carrying him on a chariot, people fanning him, people attending to all of his needs. But one day the sun came on him and he said, I'm not as powerful as I thought I was. I hope I could become the sun. He became the sun. So he felt like the most powerful element in the world, so majestic and great. No one or nothing was more powerful than he was. Until a cloud came, and the cloud blocked his power. So you know what he did next? He prayed to become the cloud. He became the cloud. Floating through the sky, stronger than anyone or anything around, he knew for sure he became the most powerful. And then one day, as a cloud, he hit a mountain. Lord, let me become that mountain. And he became the mountain. For sure, assuming it's Trinidad, he's Alto Cooch. Nothing and no one is taller than he is. He is mighty and powerful until he starts to feel on his side. Chip, chip, chip. A stone cutter was more powerful than he was. You see, sisters and brothers, and I call us sisters and brothers because all of us were created by God. Sadly, our education system in Trinidad and Tobago is such that we always look beyond our walls. We look elsewhere to see what others are doing, and we compare ourselves to others. But like the stone cutter, I pray, I truly pray, that you recognize that you are as powerful as you choose to be as an institution. That each and every student has the ability to make something beautiful of themselves, not for their own gain, but to give back to society. On behalf of our parish community, we really congratulate you on this milestone. And as Jesus prayed in the gospel you heard me read at the beginning, my prayer for you is that you may continue to be united, continue to be one, because the way that the staff and teachers interact will determine how our future generation interact in unity. The example that we set as parents in the way we interact with each other, putting aside differences and loving each other, will determine what the next generation does. So may we be united, may we be one in love, and may we be happy with exactly who we are, because we are unique, original, one of a kind. There's no need to be any other school or institution but yourselves. Continue your wonderful work. May the will do it, but not your own will, God's will in cooperation with your own. Father, may we be one as you and I are one. Amen.
Thank you, Father Woodruff. Our next item, it's a cultural item, which is a dance performed by Maya O'Connor and Shania O'Connor. These twins, one of the many twins in our school, pursuing business studies at our school, have been active members of Girls Guides for the last 4 years under the tutelage of Miss Fullerton. They are usually involved in school activities as they perform during events such as Mother's Day and Father's Day celebration. The O'Connors are also members of the Performing Arts Club. They got their start with dancing at primary school and choreographed dances on their own thereafter. I'd like to welcome the twins, as we call them, to the stage. Let's hear it for them, please.
Tell everyone around you, but you know they've heard.
Thank you, girls, for that lovely, 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 lovely dance. And as graceful as they dance is as graceful as they walk the school compound, like swans on water, majestic. Right? Today's feature dress will be by Mr. Guy, Mr. Nanton, and Miss Marcel. So we can we ask these persons to join us here today? Mr. Guy, Mr. Nanton, and Miss Marcel.
Well, I saw my name next to the feature address. That gives me the prerogative to say good morning to all of you. And glad to be here. Always glad to associate with CUREP, and the teachers there who know me fully well know that. Very, very happy to be associated with CUREP in all its forms. This morning gives me great pleasure to be here again and to address you. And when I look at the theme, really, I would have been very glad to address the theme here, just those three, stronger in spirit, deeper in wisdom, united in purpose. However, it didn't seem to me that this was the scope of my duty when I was told, and therefore I'm not going to be addressing those. But this theme is very profound, and I really, really hope that it could be explored at a different time, because it's very, very profound. And I could see that CUREP Junior Secondary is really getting stronger in spirit. Of course, after 50 years, though age doesn't bring wisdom, as people say, but it affords a lot of experience so that you apply knowledge and so you have wisdom. So don't just think that it comes automatic with age. You develop it. It's an attitude, united in purpose. However, this morning, as I said, I'm accompanied by two young people. You know, my association with CUREP goes back to the last just over 26 years. And it's as if it's the same. Every day I'm invited, it seemed to be the first day I walk into the school when Mr. Encinas was here. All right, so this morning what we are gonna do, we cannot cover 50 years in the time allotted to us in terms of looking at decade upon decade. So what we have decided to do, that's Mr. Nanton, who's the youngest of us all, and Miss Marcel, and myself, who's the oldest of all. What we have decided to do, I'm going to look at the first few years, CUREP in the first stage, and Mr. Nanton would look at CUREP when we converted and deshifted, and Mrs. Marcel is going to look at the CUREP as it is now, or after the deshifting. So that's what we'll do. And in terms of the history of the school, because of time, again, we can't do much in terms of that. Now, just before we continue, we recognize that when you speak of stronger and wiser and so forth, we realize that there were many who laid the groundwork for us. And some of the pillars, some of the foundation members have passed. Some of our school students have also passed. We lost some even during COVID. And so at this time, I'd like to invite the congregation, all of you, all of us, to stand and to spend a moment in silent reflection of the contribution that they would have made. Our moment begins now. Thank you very much. You may be seated. Let me just say, never begrudge the moment that you spend alone. Never begrudge the moment. Spend those times in reflection. The Bible says that the house of sadness is more instructive than the house of joy. Okay, so I move on. So our purpose this morning is really to give you a snippet into the history and life of our beloved school on its golden anniversary. Many of us, you young people, are not 50. Trust to God that if Christ doesn't come soon enough, that you would live to see that milestone. So today, as we look back, we are reflecting on the powerful pillars and the broad shoulders of the institution, quickly touching on the phases, as I mentioned to you. Curb Jr. said before it was, when it was a shift system, and then when we would de-shift it, the school's name was changed to St. Joseph Secondary, the shifting and conversion. And so the last days, as it is now, is St. Joseph Secondary. Now, we are well aware that many of us, and I should say many of you, have the history better in your head and could relate to it better than we can. And I was very happy to hear the history and the experience of Mr. Ramjatan. I, from time to time, meet students because of the wrinkles in my face now, and when I was young, I had an afro, they recognize me, but I don't recognize them because some of them have grown beard and so. And I'm always happy to meet them because most of them I meet, they are very proud that they attended Curep Junior Secondary. And in fact, I'll tell you this much, I had a couple nieces who attended that school, did very well. And I encourage them to come there. And there are some students I encourage to stay there. The application, you young people who are still students, your application is what determines your success. Let's go on. So the school opened in September 1972 with a shift system, having an enrollment of about 640 students. The principal, Mr. Andrew Rup Singh, and so he had two vice principals because we had a morning shift and an evening shift. I'm told that the turnover of staff was so regular, it seems that St. Joseph Secondary was a place where people came and left. To my mind, that's very good because in my mind, I'm understanding that St. Joseph Secondary, as Curep Junior Secondary, was a nursery for other schools. So as the teachers came in, you know, the supervisors and these others looked and saw the talent and said, "Now, too many good people are here. Let me transfer you out." So I understand that even the vice principals, among them, there was a quick turnover. I'm not going to name any vice principal because of time. There would be another occasion for that, hopefully. So the principal was in charge of the two shifts. And I'm indebted to some of the information there from the 10th anniversary. So there was a 10th anniversary celebration, and the name of that the magazine that was printed then is Our World. Our World. Because I hate to throw away things. I saw a lot of paper when I went to that school. A lot of paper in a box. And of course, I love to read those things. And so in going through, I discovered that magazine, Our World. I doubt many of you would have that. I still have it. It's a little worm-eaten and what have you, but a treasure anyhow. Okay. I found out that the school suffered from burglary, vandalism, stray animals, floods, and as I just mentioned, frequent turnover of staff and also bushes outside the fence. I just leave those complaints. Those all of us who have worked there have first-hand information. So Don't blame yourself. It's a perennial problem, over 50 years old. So don't bother. Do what you could do and don't bother. QAP Junior Secondary was not overcome by its problems. It surmounted them and excelled in many areas, thanks to the dedicated teachers and the disciplined students. The school managed to capture quite a few trophies. It took part, it participated in different competitions, debatings, scrabbling competitions, sports, example, cricket, football, and some other activities. A visit to the school's office has a display of some, not all, some of the trophies that were won. Many students from the school excelled even as they graduated from secondary, senior secondary, and senior comprehensive school. I need not go more with that. You had a sterling example of Mr. Ramjatan. Very good. Now, this system continued for decades. And indeed, at one time, QAP Junior Secondary was ranked as one of the best junior secondary school on the East-West Corridor, if not the whole country. Come on, I'm not hearing you. I'm not hearing you. I'm not hearing you. So as I take my seat and hand over to Mr. Nanton, I want all you students, all you parents, the last PTI I attended there, I was quite disappointed that the parents were not as supportive as I feel they could be, could do. I'm hoping, and I'll say that publicly, whether I live to pass out through the gate, that's not my business. I'm really hoping and praying that sometime next year we'd have a series of activities, even reaching to the airwaves of the country, to let people know the good work that has been doing right near that flood-prone area, QAP Junior Secondary, because we have been doing great work. And as the Bible says, Jesus says, nobody lights a candle and hide it. The candle is supposed to be on the hill. And for 50 years, QAP has been hiding its candle. I constantly say, I look on Morning Edition and these shows, and I do not see representative from QAP. And I think that come next year, that something should be put in place whereby it's time for the nation to know what has been happening. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Guy, giving us that reflection from QAP Junior Secondary School. But then came a time where the school transitioned into an unprecedented season, which demanded flexibility and fluidity from students, staff, and faculty. This period saw an exponential growth in the student population, which at that time was compounded of a mixture between two arms of the school, morning and evening, morphing into one, becoming what we know today as St. Joseph Secondary School. In this era, I had the enviable and invaluable experience of being among the first cohorts of students to enter the hallways of SJS as a 5-year educational institution, an accomplishment I still hold dearly to heart to this day. I can recall the many challenges in navigating these uncharted waters, rough with obstacles of truancy, delinquency, instability, and hardship. However, through this era, it was the resilience of those with the intent to ensure the success of the institution and the students that underscored its motto, "The Will Does It." It was a period where we saw one principal lacing her sneakers and literally tackling some very mature students, some over 18 at that time, and in another, in her high heels, commanding the respect of such an office, later seeing to the expulsion of some continuing the mandate of returning the school to some semblance of order and overall progress. Those two individuals are here today, and I'm just going to salute them both. In hindsight, one could examine the inroads made in vocational, extracurricular, and student life areas of the school. Consequently, the staff placed great emphasis on alleviating the proliferation of narcotics and illegal items and activities in the school, and instead created positive avenues and outlets of expressions with the establishment of the student council, school choir, choral speaking, drama, pan, basketball, and football clubs, just to name a few. Perhaps this is where the real spirit of the students combine to demonstrate the potential and capabilities despite being pegged against all seemingly insurmountable odds. It was the odds of the rift between the Bangladesh community and the students, the emotional baggage of students displaced and outpoured during school hours, and the never-ending saga of attaining a compound which was conducive and concomitant with contemporary and modern settings for safety and learning. This challenge, not new, still persists now as we celebrate this major milestone here. In this light, we saw many students and clubs entering and placing in competitions such as Sandfest, Panorama, and Junior Calypso Monarchs in the Arts, and cooking competitions from the home economics and food nutrition classes in the vocational field to the members of the football team debuting in the Trinidad and Tobago Secondary Schools Football League. Superior to these, arguably, is its heritage in the Trinidad and Tobago Secondary Schools Basketball League, where SJS's male and female teams dominated, capturing several championships from 2009 to 2019. Over time, we saw the emerging of the staple gospel concert put on by the Student Council, aptly coined Lift Up His Name, from one of our past faculty, Christambu Herbert. Hit song and put on by the St. Joseph Secondary School Student Council. The SJSSC, then and now, that being the Student Council, continues to be a catalyst for change within the school environment, redefining and enhancing the students' role in education and school life. Admittingly, some here might even remember the good old year the council almost led a revolution in which students, up in arms over the school's condition and the silent protest of teachers, almost charged through the main entrance of the school. It too showed the life of the students and the spirit of the school to face and challenge the status quo and reshape its reality. Then there came the incident where the ever famous cafeteria owner and his staff were egged on by a class of students, resulting in the cancellation of graduation that year. Oh, the memories. Memories for some fall in the realm of re-traumatization and re-victimization of the mere thought of getting up and preparing themselves to face SJS's hallways, which could have been, and for some, still be very painful to the expense of their mental health, well-being, equilibrium, and balance. For others, though, it brings with them an overwhelming joy and happiness of the many lifelong friends gained, meaningful lessons learned, and some beautiful moments that cannot be traded and replaced. Regardless of the spectrum, it cannot be downplayed or overlooked that the institution presses on to impact and transforms lives to a place where they can have noteworthy contributions for their families, their communities, and their country.
Ladies and gentlemen, I take careful note that Mr. Nanton did not mention that he was a part of that class that egged down the cafeteria. I see he's not much reformed either. When I entered the school in 2006, it was at the brink of the crossroads of the old and new. The principal at the time was Mr. Prakash Williams, and the vice principals were Mrs. Reyes and Mrs. Alfonso. The years flew quickly, ushering in the leadership of Mrs. Joan Porter Samuel as principal, followed by Ms. Cheryl Julian, and the school is now led by Mr. Wazir Mustafa, with Mrs. Charmaine Mohammed Hoyt serving as vice principal. These are just a few people that were a part of the school's administration over time who were aptly supported by a dedicated team of staff. Nonetheless, during my time in the office, I was able to see firsthand the school's transformation from a two-shift, three-year junior secondary system to a full five-year secondary school. Now, this may sound like an easy transition in theory, but it demanded a heapload of work, particularly from the administration, which had to charter a new course to adapt to a change in the system and an increase in student population. It also meant a lot of typing for me. It required somewhat of a rewiring of one's mindset and an intentional quest towards the change of a culture. Students had to get accustomed to longer days and the newness of additional staff and teachers, and teachers had to acquaint themselves, fitting themselves into workspaces once meant and designed for a smaller population. That gave rise to the prefab element of the school, the only consolation being the air conditioning. The issue of accommodating CSEC and its subjects also had to be factored in, as labs and other facilities needed to be expanded to meet the requirements of those subject areas and to cater for the needs of the student population, particularly those who had the desire to pursue sciences or vocational studies. It was a grueling period that many, in hindsight, might have given a hard pass. It begs the question, though, who would resist the idea of half-day workdays now? On another token, during my tenure at St. Joseph Secondary, the school persevered and arose to the occasion. It has embarked on a number of noteworthy and admirable projects, such as the Global School Partnership, an initiative of the British Council in which SJS partnered with the St. Thomas Aquinas RC School of Glasgow, Scotland. Both schools exchanged creative arts and environmental science projects during that partnership. There was also the Youth with a Purpose Foundation, YWAP, which catered to the many needs of students and the wider community through charitable outreaches. There was also the Inter-School Christian Fellowship, ISCF, Religious Instruction, and the RBC Young Leaders. As Mr. Nanton would have mentioned before, there was participation in Sandfest, School Panorama, Calypso and Soca Monarch competitions, School Parang competitions, and many others that we participated in and excelled. And that spoke to this commitment to grow and evolve regardless. And this is why St. Joseph Secondary can boast of being one of a few schools, if not the only school, in Trinidad and Tobago with a structured program for Diabetes Awareness Week, which began in 2014. It is an annual week-long series of activities culminating in a walkathon aimed at promoting diabetes education and prevention, led by home economics teacher Mrs. Charmaine Spencer-Stewart, supported by various arms of the school. And our walkathon is next week Friday. You're invited to attend. You can see Mrs. Spencer-Stewart after the program. Equally, over the years, students had the opportunity to travel to other countries, such as Antigua, with the school steel orchestra, Blazers of Steel, Scotland with the British Council, and most recently to London, United Kingdom with the Cosmetology Club. We now have a vibrant football team. We have a vibrant basketball team, netball teams, and a number of extracurricular after-school clubs, such as cheerleading, lawn tennis, weight training, athletics, badminton, and others, all run by various teachers and the school safety department. Our house system was recently revamped and instituted by the PE department, and we were able to host two school sporting events before the COVID period, where the students and staff alike brought out their competitive spirits in fierce but friendly competition between the houses of Carnarvon, Herbert, Bernard, Noel, and Guy, which is named after the esteemed gentleman to my right. On that score, I find it ironic that I stand here with him today, one, as a proud member of the Guy House, and two, really, and two, as the teacher who has taken his place in the school's staffing establishment since it was his post that was converted to introduce two new subjects to the school's curriculum, which I now teach. Yeah. I take your work, Mr. Guy. The COVID-19 pandemic was yet another challenge for us at St. Joseph Secondary. However, it did not deter teaching and learning from taking place. The management at SJS was creative and proactive, forming what is known as the task force, which is made up of members of the teaching staff and administration, to create a website and online learning platform with checks and balances to ensure our students could continue to be afforded high quality education in a controlled environment and to maintain a vibrant social media presence, again proving that the will does it. So, we'd like to invite the congregation to stand as we celebrate the contribution of all the staff of the school, teaching and non-teaching, whether they have been transferred, retired, or are still working.
We want you to join us with a lusty round of applause to commemorate all the students, past and present, who are making a meaningful contribution wherever they are.
Thank you, and congratulations to St. Joseph Secondary on its golden anniversary.
Please be seated. Thank you.
All right. Thank you for that wonderful journey through the history of CUREP, Junior Sec, and St. Joseph Secondary. All right. I don't know if you realize that we tailored the feature address to signify the three categories of time: past, present, and the future. Right. I believe that if you are a part of an institution, whether it be it a school, company, or whatever else, that it is important that you know the history of the institution, why things are done the way it is. And on that note, we come to the part where we want to recognize past contributions to St. Joseph Secondary. Items like school song, school motto, and other stuff. So I'll ask Miss Nero to please come to the stage as we recognize those who has contributed to the various items of our school. Thank you.
We want to take this time to recognize many of the firsts that took place within our school. The first person I want to acknowledge is Mr. Roop Singh, who could not join us today. He was our school's first principal. Please give him a round of applause. Secondly, I do want to wish the school's fourth principal, Ms. Porter Samuel, to join us in front as we recognize another of our firsts. Ms. Porter Samuel will be giving a token of appreciation to Mr. Clive Ramjatan, the person, the first student body, a member of the first student body, who was recognized as the person who designed our school's motto and our logo. Thank you, Ms. Porter. Secondly, I will ask the fifth principal of our school, Ms. Cheryl Julian, to join us as we Ryan. As we also recognize another first, our school anthem was created by two teachers. One did the lyrics and one did the melody. Today, we want to acknowledge Mr. Carnavon and following Giselle, my house is named after him. We would like to welcome Mr. Carnavon to collect a token of appreciation on behalf of our school. I hope Bernard is seeing green. Now, when the school first started, I understand that it was teachers who manned the school's library. However, there was one teacher who was passionate about it, and even though she could not be with us today, I still want to recognize Miss Harriet, who was passionate about the library, so much so that she became a librarian. I would like to invite our present acting principal, Mr. Mustafa, to the front. We tried to keep the trend going, so for the 50th anniversary, we asked for students of Ms. Martin's art class to come up with a 50th anniversary logo. The students whose logo was eventually used is a young lady by the name of Miss Christiana, I think it's Rosales of 4.4. Mr. Mustafa, I would like you to stay there also for us to recognize Miss Martin for her contribution in supporting Christiana. Carnarvon House is still on the stage. Bernard House, behave. And for making the final product, touching up that logo and designing our banner, among other things, I also want to recognize Miss Briggs. So she's responsible for the bookmark, the banner, etc. Yes. Thank you, Miss Briggs. Thank you, Mr. Mustafa. I'll hand over to the MC. Do say nothing about Bernard House, yeah?
As a true Bernard member, you know we keep it healthy. Yes? Bernard, can I get a hello? Amen. Right. Humble yourself, child. Right. So, as we move on today, next item, we have a cultural item, instrumental by Michelle Williams? I'll say yes. No, yes. Oh, my apology. It's a cultural item, an instrumental by Aaliyah Samuel of 3.2, Tessa Backus of 2.3, Mia Francis of 5.3 and Alyssa Mejas of 5.3. Well done, ladies. That was really lovely. Really, really, really nice. Could we give them another clap? Yeah. So we have another item, which is going to be led by Mr. Mark Nichols. We have Chelsea Walters of 4.5, Sharifa Knights of 4.2, Natalia Clark of 4.3, Jeremiah Beckles of 5.1, and Faith Roach of 5.4. Could we give them a round of applause, please?
Thank you.
All right, when Jesus say yes, and I'm sure he's saying yes to that performance. Let's hear it for them again. Now I'd like to welcome Mrs. Hossein to the stage to give the vote of thanks to the various stakeholders. Mrs. Hossein.
Good morning, everyone. So I have here with me my little helper, the adopted, one of our adopted St. Joseph Secondary students, Gadaiva Hossein, my daughter. So I am very honored to be here to express appreciation on behalf of the school for reaching this milestone. This was an event that could not have been undertaken without the help of so many persons assisting. So it cannot be a short thank you. Unfortunately, this is the longest vote of thanks I've ever had to do. So first, Mr. Mustafa, thank you very much for recognizing the significance of St. Joseph Secondary being in existence for 50 years. Come stand here. And also for making the proposal for the function and for this lovely holiday that we get to have tomorrow for some rest. Yeah? And we also like to thank the Ministry of Education for approving this proposal. We have had many specially invited guests here today and presenters, and we are very grateful to you for accepting the invitation and being present here today. Well, we're aware that unfortunately some were not able to make it, but we'd still like to acknowledge them and thank them for their consideration. So we would like to say thank you to the PTA president, Ms. Habiba Abdul-Jabbar, for being here, the St. Joseph Secondary alumni, Mr. Clive Ramjatan. There are the counselors of St. Joseph and Maracas Santa Margarita, Mr. Kurt DeFreitas and Corey Selwan. Thank you for being here. And thank you for assisting us in undertaking this event. We were also privy to a lot of history about St. Joseph Secondary in the various reflections from Mr. Guy, Mr. Nanton, and Ms. Marcel, as well as the reflection from Father Mikkel Woodruff. Thank you very much. And as we've learned, there were several key persons who laid the foundation of the school. And as I mentioned before, some could not be here, but we'll still like to acknowledge them: Mr. Roop Singh, Mr. Clive Ramjatan, Mr. Pierre, Mr. Carnavon, Ms. Harriet, and our presenters for those persons, Ms. Porter Samuel, Ms. Cheryl Julian. And as we know, no function could really be a function. And in terms of St. Joseph Secondary School, we can't start without our prayer, our national anthem, and our school anthem, as well as our school song. So for the musical opening pieces, we'd like to thank Ms. Briggs for the national anthem, Mrs. Clinton Delas for the school anthem, and Mr. Herbert, fellow Blue House member here. Thank you for the school song. And sincere thanks with, you know, as Mr. Mirage rightfully said, we are a multicultural school, and it is a true reflection by starting our function with the various school prayers, the various prayers reflecting our different religions. So thanks, Ms. Martha Udan, Mr. Hossein, and Ms. Gopi for leading us in their words of prayer. This had also set the tone, more or less, for the various cultural events, performances that we were able to witness and enjoy. Even though Makeda Henry wasn't able to be here and perform, there was a lot of effort put into... Oh, yes, you are, sorry. Right, Sabrina Williams, sorry. There was still a lot of effort that was put forth in the preparation, so thanks Makeda Henry, the instrumental pieces, Alia Samuel, Maya Francis, Tessa Bacchus, Alyssa Mejias, and the dances by those graceful girls, Maya and Shania O'Connor, as well as the reading by Andrew Davis. And of course, we saw some of our talent in the recognition of the 50th anniversary logo, which was done by Christiana. And I almost forgot to thank for that last lovely performance led by Mr. Nichols, McNichols, Chelsea Walters, Sharifa Knight, Natalia Clark, Jeremiah Beckles, and Faith Roberts. Roach. Faith Roach. As we move on, I'd like to highlight the various teams that were critical in putting together and ensuring the smooth running of this function. We had our technical committee, which encompassed Mr. Brent Louis for the live stream, who was also assisted by Mr. Ashram, Ms. Beatty Luton for overseeing the sound function, sound system, Ms. Ashby and Mr. Mirage, who are masters of ceremony. So thank you all. And if there are any technical committee members that I haven't mentioned, I know there is a film crew, which was led by Ms. Gray, as well as the Digital Media Club, and members of the Form 1.3 and Form 3.3 students. Kimora Defoe, Isaiah Batiste, who were part of the stage crew led by Miss Nero, who was the stage manager. Thank you very much for ensuring all of the collaboration in this. And of course, in order to get this all together, we needed a planning committee. From my understanding, the logistics, in order to get the logistics together, each member of the committee was tasked and therefore spearheaded various aspects of the 50th anniversary celebration, which we have here today. So some of those things included the invitations and correspondences, the programs, transportation, which included transportation of the decorations, the food, students, meal and drink arrangements, the social event, which follows. The persons that I refer to as part of this committee were Mr. Plaza, Mr. Manuel, Ms. Pear, Mrs. Seeley Liverpool, Ms. Alexis, Ms. Judan Ramratan, Ms. Beddo, Mrs. Marshall O'Connell, and I aware that Ms. Seapole was also of special assistance in putting together the program. Along with these members of staff, there are two students who we'd like to make special mention of. That is Janaya Assing and Mia Francis. They were very instrumental in ensuring things like the tokens that were received. Students were ready for the dress rehearsal, and there were several other special arrangements that they were part and parcel of. And as we speak and as this show goes on, they are still assisting. So thank you, Janaya, and thank you, Mia Francis, for your assistance. And I know Ms. Nero also previously mentioned Ms. Brigg and Ms. Martin for the banner and the logo, but still, we'd like to make mention again for your contribution. And in continuing, as Miss Martha Udan provided us with such a beautiful prayer. She was also key in assisting us with obtaining donations from the Fatima Arsi's Church, as well as getting other donations from various other sources. And I previously mentioned as well the counselors for Maracas, Santa Margarita, Mr. Corey Salvan, as well as the police service for your support. And of course, we are here. We are here at a specific location. So thank you, Father Mike Michael Woodrow, for arranging and allowing us the use of this parish to host this function. In the planning, there were many persons who were consulted in order to get this function off the ground and to get ideas of, you know, with a template to follow. So we'd like to make special mention. I'll pause on that. So appreciations is going all to Father Michael Woodruff as well. Thank you very much. Going back to where I left off, in order to get this event off the ground, many persons were consulted. Reference was made to the 40th anniversary celebration as well, and a key person in guiding the team was Miss Julian, who was a former principal of our school. So thank you, Miss Julian, for your guidance and your support. And I do hope that many of you noticed that I left out someone from the planning committee. That planning committee couldn't have come together without Miss Nero. Miss Nero was very, very, very key to getting this whole thing going. You know, there's a saying that you don't like to be witness, right? Because we know what happens to witnesses. But this is an occasion I'd like to say that I witnessed, where she actually, you know, came up to the staff room and she said, you know, you all, we heard about this 50th anniversary that we have to have, but I don't know what's happening. I'm going and talk to Mr. Mustafa. And she went down and she got approval and she got things going. So she put the committee together and, I'm mistaken, I guess. But anyway, she has been at the forefront of this planning of this event. And, you know, there's this, you know, an idea would only remain an idea without an action. And if the 50th anniversary had remained an idea, we would not be here, we would not be celebrating in what is our 50th anniversary of our school. So thank you, Miss Nero, for taking the lead on this. And as I'm wrapping up, I hope. I'd also like to thank, all of our past and present teachers. We know the teaching service is an underappreciated one, but, you know, St. Joseph Secondary has really stood the tests of time, and I say tests of time, for 50 years. And that would not have been possible without the staff that has been there and is currently there. So special thank you to all involved in the running of our school and ensuring that the business of our school continues. Right, so this would include the administration, the teachers and supporting staff, two teachers, security personnel, MTS, personnel, as well as the key persons in a school compound or students, so past and present students, as well as your parents, because of course you need parents to guide you. If I have forgotten, I humbly and sincerely ask for forgiveness if I've overlooked or forgotten to mention anyone who has contributed in any way. As I mentioned, there were very, very many aspects to planning this event, and it could not have been done with, you know, from the big event of actually planning it to maybe even moving a chair. So if I have overlooked anyone, I ask your forgiveness, and I would like to express our sincere appreciation. I'd like to express our sincere appreciation for your support and your assistance in making this occasion a successful and memorable one. And I'd like to get back to Mr. Mustafa to thank you for opening this door for me. As we forge ahead to 50 years, maybe we can realize one of our visions, which we see every day, our new school. So maybe in the next 15 years, we can forge forward to accomplishing that, right? So in accordance, with our team, may we continue to be strong in spirit, deep in wisdom, and united in purpose. So here's to 50 more years. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mrs. Hossain. Now, as much as we would like to stand here for the next 5 hours and celebrate our school and our rich history, we have to close the curtain on such a wonderful ceremony. Right? On behalf of Ms. Ashby and myself, I must say it has been a pleasure hosting this event. And as we say goodbye, I just want to ask God to continue to bless us as a school and bless us as a family as well. Right? Always remember, the will does it. Forever and for always, St. Joseph Secondary.
As we leave here today, I hope students who were able to witness this would be able to take away something today, right? 50 years is a very long time. It is a milestone. Not many people get to reach it, right? Before we leave, staff, you're asked to remain so that a photo could be taken for Publications Committee for our magazine. Also, on your way out, there are light refreshments that you will take with you to the school's compound where lunch will be served. Yes, both teachers and invited guests. So again, please stand. And with three chairs for 50th anniversary of St. Joseph Secondary, hip hip,
hooray!
Hip hip,
hooray!
Hip hip,
hooray!
Thank you very much, God bless.